Life is a world full of uncertainty, with nothing to fall back and hope for. We hear news of terror, strife, lack, bad news, and this all makes us question where our hope lies. Perhaps there's a time in your life that you have felt this hopelessness, or you probably may be at a point right now where you are feeling hopeless. It happens, hopelessness happens, when you find yourself in a situation where there is no confident expectation of a positive outcome. It's almost like being end of your rope. Certain examples that we could look at is probably the death of a spouse or a child, or a financial crisis, or a breakdown in a relationship, or a loss of a job, or even natural disasters that kills and buries our hope. The question that we have for today is, what is my hope? The Bible says that Christ is my living hope. We read from scripture from 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 3. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. The word hope, as we understand in the English dictionary, means wishful thinking or something that does not have a certain outcome. We probably hear it in words such as, I don't know what's going to happen, but I hope it happens. Human hope fails in comparison with the hope that is assured to us in the Bible. Hope, as the Word of God talks about, is characterized by certainty and is the confident expectation of the promises of God. It is not a hope that wishes for things to happen, but it is a solid, concrete evidence on the Word of God. There's no ambiguity there. So what is the object and the source of our hope? Christian hope is built on the person of Jesus Christ. He is the source of all our hope. Because of what Christ did for us in our sinful condition, it enables us to know that we do not stand in judgment, or we are not in condemnation, because all things work together for our good. And because he died and he rose for us, therefore all the promises of God for this life and for eternity are yes and amen in him. So how can you and I be intentional about living this hope, even though all around us we see hopelessness? Firstly, it is by taking time to remind ourselves who we are in Christ, and also to understand the riches he has bestowed on us as our inheritance. So let's stay in the Word. Let's pray the Word. Let's meditate on the Word, because it is his Word that gives us life. The love letter from God is the key to all our hopefulness. So let's take a look away from each of our circumstances that confront us, whether it be challenges we face at work, or challenges we face at home, or the challenges we face outside. And let's look to the promises and hold fast to them, because hope comes from the promises of God that is rooted in the work of Christ. Shall we pray together? Father God, we thank you because you are our living hope. You are the source of all our hope. Even when we are desperate and hopeless in our situations, whether it be in our homes, at our workplaces, or in our nation, Father, we know that we can fix our eyes on the perfecter and finisher of our faith. We pray that we will stand on your word. We will know your word, because it is through your word that we find hope for our tomorrows. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.